Hello, Twitch. It may be a quiet and lonely night tonight. We got the presidential debate that I don't really want to get into watching because why watch two people lie to me? So, still we're going to work on comics and have a good time. This was literally just revealed. I finished this like 2 hours ago and it's already posted out in the real world. It's for Warnicorns, which will be launching on Kickstarter in 2 days, I think they said. So, yeah, it's pretty cool. And it's kind of a two-piece thing. So I've got, you know, obviously this one, which I'm going to actually... You okay, Moose? He just did like the weirdest burp. Let's kind of make this a little darker. Anyway. But yeah, so they've already kind of put this out in the world and revealed it to everybody. It's literally kind of hot off the presses, but there's a second part to it, which is here on the right. Essentially, this character is taking a selfie, and so this is the selfie of that picture. So, it was mandated that essentially what's supposed to be happening is she's going to be in focus, and everything else is out of focus. You know, it's a short depth of field, so all those guys are going to be blurred. So, and since, you know, this kind of had a flash on her, you know, his eyes were closed, so it just kind of made sense to put a flash on that piece. My finger itches. Hold on. And so, because these background elements on this piece, you know, are going to be blurred, I'm probably just going to do that first just to get it out of the way. So I try not to spend too much time on it. So this piece in general, I'll do a bit differently than I kind of typically approach. That's all right. So I'm just going to deselect this area. So, yeah, so. Right, she's isolated. Now I can just kind of block these dudes in real kind of quick and easy. But I see I've already kind of done all the work over here, so I don't need to do a whole lot. I don't have to figure a lot out. I've already figured it out over here, so that's why I left this open. I could just sample my colors and move along. I'm not gonna select anything. I'm just essentially indicating the shapes. And I will end up isolating this, isolating the line art for this area that's in the background. And I'm gonna blur it all. Kind of going against my normal feel and vibe. I'm trying to, like, oh, I need to go put a selection here and do this, and then it's like, no, I don't need to do that. So, there was a period of time I was pretty into, like, blurring line art and stuff, and I still do on occasion, but I don't do it very often anymore. It's a really cool effect, but more often than not, it's quite a bit of extra work for not a lot of payoff. So I kind of just really wait for specific instances or do it more as when there's not a background drawn, you know, and then I'll try and create kind of a blurry depth of field background or something. I did more of that in the series May. I colored with Gene Ha. That was kind of something that he established in his first issue that he did and that he colored and painted himself. So I tried to just kind of stay on board with what he already established. But yeah, these I need to get these done. I've got, so I just finished this other one, this one on the left here, about 2 hours ago. Got it approved really quick, which is nice. That doesn't always happen. Sometimes you gotta wait a good while, and more often than not, the longer you have to wait, the more changes you end up getting. So I'm not a huge fan of having to wait to hear back, because it usually means I have more work to do. But that should be probably Green Dude. But no, I came back real quick. But they were already hitting up the artist. Artist is Ryan Kincaid, by the way. You know, done a bit of work together before. We started, he did some covers for one of Marat Michaels and Counterpoint Comics. One of their series, I forgot which one, that I ended up doing. Yeah. Unknown to, I think I found out to both of us, Brian and myself at the time, they ended up wanting a series of covers that connected. You know, so, and all their covers have like multiple patches and addendums to it, so each cover is usually 2 to 3 separate images, which that's okay. But we didn't know it was going to be kind of a series of covers. So it was like, I think it was across like 3 issues. So it was like 3 issues and it was basically the same design for each one, but we didn't know that going in. Because it was very similar background. It wasn't the exact same, but it was very, very similar. But there was a lot of stuff I probably, had we known going in, Ryan and I could have both like approached it a little differently and made it a little less work for ourselves. But that's kind of where it all started. That's where our first collaboration kind of started, was we did a series. And fortunately, he liked what I did. Marat liked what I did. And after that, like, talked to Ryan off and on a little bit, did a Plastic Man piece, a commission that he had done that he wanted colored that I think came out pretty cool. I think he liked it too. And yeah, just kind of we didn't keep close touch, but we did a couple pieces here and there, but eventually I just got, we had the baby and it was just busy, and I didn't have a whole lot. And then this past summer, I kind of put out there like, hey, I need some work. Give me some work. And he's like, oh, you're free. I got work for you. And he just kind of dropped a bunch of them on me. And that's been really cool, man. He's kept me pretty busy this summer with several different pieces. So some for his own properties, just some for variant covers for his own comic that he's launching, and then some of it for stuff he drew for other people. Either way, I mean, it's been cool. I've met him a couple times in person at conventions, and seems like a very, very laid back individual. Laid back, but still very straightforward. Like he doesn't mess around, which is really cool. You know, when he gets involved with things, he wants it to be. You know, he wants it to be good, but he also wants it to be worth his time. So that's somebody I can get behind. Oh, my goodness. Oops. And that is my dog Moose scratching that you just heard. He has a, he's got all his tags and everything like that, but I gave him an old, Superman keychain I've had for, oh my goodness, probably since I was 13, 14, that my mom gave me from the old Warner Brothers store that used to be in town. It's just, one, it's incredibly well made, and it's just really freaking cool. And I haven't really ever wanted to get rid of it. And then I got too many keys. You grow up, you don't tell you how many keys you end up collecting. And I don't know what a lot of them are for, except when I do need them, then I know exactly what they're for. When I don't need them, I can't figure it out. Go figure. But yeah, then got married, and he was my wife's dog, and I just, like, you need this. It's like, I can't bring myself to throw it away. So, I gave it to Moose. So now it makes clanking sounds when he, scratches. I'm trying to outthink myself, and it's not really working. So I had to do this because whenever I do blur it, it's gonna obviously run into the other areas. And so if I have these really sharp edges of the main character's color up front, it's gonna look weird. Oops, I missed some lines. So this will just help kind of lessen some of that sharpness. Totally screwed the pooch on that. Oh, I did this backwards. And there you got your blurred background for the selfie. I think that works okay. Keep forgetting to turn that on. I've actually come to like really enjoy coloring here. When it's drawn like this, it's just kind of therapeutic and fun. Got the hair done. Save, so make sure you save. Always super important. I guess everybody has ended up going to the presidential debate tonight. That's all right. That just means I get more work done than I'm sitting there chatting. It's not that I don't care about what's going on. I've come to already realize and accept that whatever happens in this debate tonight doesn't matter. I guarantee you. Guarantee you, most every single person that's actually going to go vote probably already determined who they're voting for, and this will not change anything. So, why invite any more of the chaos? We're still a month out, month and a half out from the election, and I'm already tired of the politics. It's exhausting. It's annoying. People aren't nice, and people are very dumb right now. So, make comics, not drama. The drama I like to make is in my comics. I don't need any more drama in life. 2020 has been enough drama as it is.
This is what cash sounds like.
Ka-ching!
This is what winning Extremely Extreme Cash sounds like.
Ka-ching!
Play the Extreme Cash scratch tickets from the Texas Lottery today. You could win top prizes from $5,000 up to $1 million and experience what Extremely Extreme sounds like.
Ka-ching! Ka-ching! Ka-ching!
For details,
additional game odds and information, visit txlottery.org or call
800-375-6888. Gotta clean that circle up.
Older to purchase a ticket. Play responsibly.
The design sketch is finished. The final stitch in the factory complete. The truck has been unloaded. Shelves have been newly stocked. Everything new and needed for fall is ready at Boot Barn, and there are new ways for you to get it, including free same-day contactless curbside pickup and same-day delivery. We're safely open and making it our priority to support you down to the last detail. Boot Barn, proud supporters of the West.
Inspired by State Farm's surprisingly great rates.
It's so cheap.
It's late. You hear an ad like this for McDonald's new spicy chicken McNuggets. It's unbelievable. So you call the restaurant, which is weird, but it's true. All true. And you think, I've been lied to before, but not by McDonald's. And not by these spicy chicken McNuggets.
For a limited time at participating McDonald's.
Center to light looks mirror looks different.
When I tell it, I'm ready.
Yeah, man. You'll be safe here, buddy. I promise, Tony. Yeah, I didn't want to get into any of all that mess. I do find it really, really interesting that all of my international friends are all going on about it too, and I'm like, it doesn't really affect you, but whatever. We won't go into all that. It's going all right, man. Just trying to get this piece done. This one I'm working on is the selfie that she's taking on this cover to the left. So it's kind of a two-part. I don't know if this is going to be like the back cover or... I don't know. All I know is I'm getting paid for it. Gold Digger. You said you were doing issue 23. What's happening in that issue? I know it's after Time Warp. It's before the wedding, right? That's not the wedding stuff. Oh, yeah? One of the witches. And I don't... Cash sounds like. It's been too long. I really don't remember. Extremely extreme cash sounds like... Play the extreme cash scratch tickets from the Texas Lottery today. You could win top prizes from $5,000 up to $1 million and experience what extremely extreme. I hope you get a okay rate on those pages. For detailed game odds and information, visit txlottery.org or call 800. That was one of my big, like, maybe I won't say I'll help out because. If you're on the road, Robbie was telling me what he was getting. He was like, I was told I was going to get this, and then I got this instead. It was like half what he was told he was going to get. What he was going to get in the first place wasn't that much. So it was like, maybe I won't help. So you can celebrate from anywhere, work from anywhere, or connect. Of course, they never asked me either, but to find a Jiffy Loop near you. I almost volunteered. Anywhere is possible with Jiffy Loop. State Farm's surprisingly great rates. We gave this song surprisingly great lyrics. State Farm, prices made just for you. That's what I said now. Prices that surprise you. Just go ahead now. Keep that money in your pockets. That's on bread now. Save up. Maybe one day buy a rocket. Just get it cool now. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. The MD Anderson Proton Therapy Center gives patients the best chance at defeating cancer. With the world's leading experts in proton therapy and the research. Where'd you send it? The nation's number one messenger or what? Center. Learn more at mdandersonprotontherapy.com. Did you email it or? Skype. No, is my Skype still signed in? Whatever. It's a default to being on. I don't know why I didn't set it to that. I gotta go figure out how to turn that off. Yeah, that's good. Honestly, I probably couldn't, just like looking at it, I probably couldn't tell that it was you other like any more than I could tell it was Robbie. I would have just thought Robbie did it. So good job. Yeah, no, it looks like it. Oh, I always liked coloring Fred's stuff the few times I ever did. It was always fun. I haven't colored any of his old stuff like that, though. I think the last time I colored, what was the last thing? Maybe it was Time Lincoln? But that wasn't even me, like, flat out. I was kind of going over what Robbie was doing already. It was one of those books that I didn't have time to do myself, but I really wanted to do it, and I wanted it to look a certain way. And then Robbie got to color it, and I was like, it's not how I want it to look. I'm going to go over it. He didn't care. He did the whole thing in like 2 days anyway. So I think you should have. Why not? As long as Robbie didn't start coloring that issue, you should have just done your own style and just do what you want. Make it your own. Have fun with it. That's part of the reason I didn't end up getting into doing it, because some of that stuff I really just want to go to town on. And it would have just not been cost effective. I would have spent way too much time and energy. Yeah, bro. I think you should. Just do what you want. Have some fun with it. Make it your own thing. See, he didn't draw this line there, so I'm just gonna kind of create it in the color. How many issues are you down to do? Do you know yet? Or are you just going to like do as many as you can? Good practice. Good practice. I mean, there's definitely worse things in the world you could be coloring than gold digger. Nice. Yeah, I think 2 pages a day is a decent pace. You know, it's kind of what I end up trying to do. Like, if I get more done, great. But I try to do about 2 pages a day when I'm ever just like in full on mode. It's about the best I can manage anymore these days whenever I do get to go full time coloring. So I don't. If I try to do more than that, I don't think the work's as good. Like, I can do more and I've done more. But I think knocking out about 2 pages a day, and that averages out about, you know, 8 hours, you know, four hours per page, give or take, you know, and that's never just like straight, because I always have to pause, do email this person, check in on that. You know, there's constantly something going on. So it's rarely like start to finish in one sitting, 4 hours. So, I mean, it can end up being more like 10 to 12 by the end of the day, but it'll be about 8 hours actual color time on a piece. Or 4 hours per page, 8 hours total coloring in the day. Like, I could probably do more than that and try to do better than that, but I mean, there's more to life than just coloring comics. So yeah, like I said, life gets in the way, makes it hard. Other stuff needs to happen. You can't just be like, oh, I'm gonna sit here and color for 12 hours. Like, before, you know, responsibilities and stuff, yes, that was doable and the norm, but you know, now there are more important responsibilities and that has to take a place, you know, and it's a priority, but it's not my ultimate priority, as it should be, you know. It shouldn't be my ultimate. So you know, our mutual friends have taught me that lesson at the very least, where it can't be all about the work. As much as I enjoy the work, there's no joy if it's just all about the work. It costs too much. Everybody still healthy, or you still got your dog crap in your car, or what? Which, that both sucks, but it's also really funny. Oh no! I shouldn't laugh, but I'm going to, because it's hysterical. Oh no. Yeah, bro. You gotta like start keeping blankets or something wherever she is in the car. And but then also try and get her to go before you get in the car. Yeah, that sucks. I'm sorry. That's why. You gotta do like blankets, bro. Like something fabric-y. That's why she did it there, because it didn't have that weird feel. I feel for you. I really do. I don't mean to like be callous and just mean and laughing at you. It is funny though. Were I in your shoes, I wouldn't be laughing yet either, but you know. I bet Lissa's downstairs laughing at you right now. That's not what I want to do.
And now it's time for Riddles with Red.
What if I said you could save thousands on select in-stock homes with lenders allowing no payments for 60 days? Fine, I'll say it. You can save thousands on select in-stock homes with lenders allowing no payments for 60 days. You're welcome.
That was Riddles with Red. Save thousands on select in-stock homes during Clayton Homes Red Tag Sales Event. Not available during certain financing. Talk to the lender you choose for details and restrictions. Home centers are not mortgage lenders or brokers.
Awkward silence? Make some noise. Try Soundtrap, your everywhere studio. Packed with features for both music makers and podcasters. Make a hit, or a podcast about you making a hit. It works on any device, anywhere. Sound making is in our blood. Tap the banner to sign up for free.
What are you drinking?
Instant hydration.
Okay, I mean, I can get that from my drink.
No, you can't. Only Electrolit is perfectly formulated to work faster.
Work faster?
Electrolit's scientifically superior hydration formula helps you recover after a long workout, a long night, or just find perfect balance. It does what the other brands only promise.
Electrolit. Perfectly formulated to work faster.
Jay Farner here, CEO of Rocket Mortgage. Making the right financial decisions has never been more important. When you turn to Rocket Mortgage, we can help guide you to those right decisions now, when they matter most. Mortgage rates are near historic lows, so now is a great time to call 8338-ROCKET. And if you need some extra money, a cash-out refinance could give you that financial boost you're looking for. Call today at 8338-ROCKET or go to rocketmortgage.com to learn more.
Call for cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender. Licensed in all 50 states. NMLS number 3030.
Hey, Tony. You still there? Hi. Hey, all your webcomic friends that you still hang out and talk and chat with, see if you can get them to go give the Sasquanaut Kickstarter and Indiegogo a signal boost for me. Like, this is the awesomest comic ever. You guys should check it out and go blow it up. I don't know if they will, but it doesn't hurt to ask. Nice. But did they do it? Got their followings, man. Gotta capitalize on the followings. Get all those dudes that still owe you money or favors. Be like, yo. Like, hook it up. And this doesn't count against me. Tell them that. So, you know, I don't take your favors away.
I forgot that that's still feathered. That's alright.
NPCs always go so much faster once you already know what you're doing. This will be done here tonight. I wasn't sure if I'd get it done tonight, but having already figured out everything on the first cover, it kind of makes this super duper easy. I like it.
Jay Farner here, CEO of Rocket Mortgage. Making the right financial decisions has never been more important. When you turn to Rocket Mortgage, we can help guide you to those right decisions now, when they matter most. Mortgage rates are near historic lows, so now is a great time to call 8338-ROCKET. And if you need some extra money, a cash-out refinance could give you that financial boost you're looking for. Call today at 8338-ROCKET or go to rocketmortgage.com to learn more.
Call for cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender. License in all 50 states. And MLS number 3030.
If you like new country music, listen to Hot Country, a playlist curated by Spotify. Find your favorite artists like Luke Combs, Kelsey Ballerini, and Thomas Rhett. Tap the banner now to listen to Hot Country.
This is Sarak. I am super excited to share with you my latest project called The Sharecropper's Daughter. Now, it's officially coming out October 2nd, but for now, you can listen to the latest single off of the album called Deliverance, which was produced by the homie and label mate Evidence. Make sure y'all click the link to check it out, and be sure to follow that playlist because I will be adding more tracks soon. Enjoy. Peace and love.
My death, stress-free zone. This is best-free dome. I'm just trying to elevate. You dig?
Pros today have to do whatever the job calls for, and the Home Depot is here to help make that easier. With a wide range of delivery options, you can get what you need, from job lot quantities to small supply runs, delivered where and when you need it. Don't want to buy the tool? Rent it. We've got the most innovative products and more ways for pros to find them, in-store and online. Pros are changing, so are we. The Home Depot, how doers get more done.
You all right? Okay. Well, we're surviving, buddy. We've been trying to establish a new norm and new routine. Lissa's job has kind of dropped a surprise in her lap and had her going... made her start going into school to start doing the online teaching from school as opposed to from home. Which, you know, that's fine. But they kind of did it all of a sudden, so, you know, we had planned, like, oh, she's going back to school on October 12th, and then, like, oh, hey, guess what? Monday, you're coming to school for 2 weeks. No, kids aren't going to be there. You just have to teach from school. So... that kind of threw us for a bit of a loop, just because it was the same day I was launching Kickstarter, and I've got, you know, all these projects currently running all at the same time, and figured we had a couple more weeks before she had to go into work, and then that kind of just went away. So, which means basically I'm doing dad duty all day until about 2 o'clock when she goes down for a nap, and then hopefully she sleeps long enough to wake up when Lissa gets home, and then Lissa takes her to spend time with her and everything, and I try to continue to work. For the most part it's working out, and I work through the afternoon and night. It's not awesome, but it is what it is. It'll probably last through October once, I think, at least one, if not two, of these projects should be done by the end of October. So that'll alleviate quite a bit of stress and crazy. So, you know, maybe I'll get to spend time with the family all together, as opposed to just Kaylee during the day or just Lissa after I'm done working at night, if she hadn't already gone to bed. So, you know, we're making it work. It is what it is. Once these jobs are done, it'll ease quite a bit, I'm sure, which means I can go back to do some writing. I gotta get some scripts done and start working on coloring issue 5 of Sasquanaut. So, but yeah, baby girl's doing good. You know, she's having to learn the new routine too, but she's doing all right. On top of that, we're trying to tweak the way we eat and stuff like that. Like, we're not really changing our diet because our diet's good, but we're trying to, we're now like watching, we're like tracking the actual calories and everything we eat for a while to figure out where we need to improve. And so, you know, just lots of little things, trying to do self-improvement stuff. We still got to finish putting the house back together, you know, from all the repairs. Still got to mess the stuff in the garage. I got to get cleared out so we can park the car in there, but it's just time. Right now that's our biggest enemy. I just got too much going on that there's not time to do it. Had the contract work been done in a reasonable amount of time and done faster, you know, like it should have been, we probably wouldn't be in this situation because work wasn't quite as hectic as it is at the moment. So, you know, it is what it is. I mean, it's not bad. It's just a little crazy right now. We're trying to just keep our feet under us and but Lissa's mom's gonna come visit here at the end of the week. They've got a fall break. Both Lissa's mom and Lissa both have fall break next week, so they're both off for a week. So she's gonna come to town for a couple days. Come spend time with Kaylee. So that'll be good. So it's crazy because, like, here we are getting used to and like adjusting into this new schedule. This is the second week trying to do this new schedule with her at school. And then, like, hey, 2 weeks, we'll kind of like get a routine, and then everybody's going to be here. Lissa will be here. Her mom will be here. And so it's like we'll have a new schedule next week, and then we'll have to kind of try and readapt back into it the following week. So it's kind of – and the following week, they're supposed to have kids going back to school. So who knows what that's going to bring. Like, it's already enough of a headache just doing with the staff. Now they're going to have to deal with the kids, which, you know, that's all well and good, but you don't know who's done what, where anybody's gone, and the company that is in charge of the school seems to be making some questionable decisions. I don't know all the details, but it's just kind of like, one, huh? They're sort of trying to be compliant with like CDC and stuff like that, but also not really, because, you know, they have elementary schools and middle schools and high schools, and like for high schools they put limits and mandates like, oh, you can only have this many kids in the class and this and that, and they're made that mandated across all their campuses, but they're not doing that for the younger kids, which doesn't make sense. You know, younger kids who have less of a grasp of what's going on, whereas high schoolers are kind of grown up enough that they should know better, and yeah, they're still going to act out, but you can punish them, whereas, you know, a child who has no real grasp of what's actually happening, you can't really punish them for playing with their mask or screwing around. So it's just kind of like, like I said, it's stuff seems a little weird, seems questionable. There's loads of details that haven't been given to staff, and, you know, kids are supposed to be coming back and they're off all next week, and here it is the middle of the week before technically kids are coming back, and nobody knows what's happening. So good times. Or even if the kids are actually coming back there, or if it's going to be postponed another week. Like, nobody knows. It's going to be kind of like this, where it's just like days before, except the days before on this is going to be, you know, vacation. So, it's ludicrous. About the worst way you could run a business, I guess, is what's going on. So, you know. All right. I think this is technically done. So, I'm gonna get a JPEG made and send it out to the people that need to see it. Well, cool, man. That actually went quite a bit faster than expected. I like it. I don't have to really worry about it too much. Save that. Boom, CMYK. Let me just do my little pop. I like to do this when I do convert it from RGB to CMYK. Once it's all flattened, I do a little adjustment of the levels just to help do a last second kind of pop of colors. But I learned that from my buddy Rod Espinoza, and It works.
It's hard to believe that not too long ago, this beautiful outdoor
When you're low-res JPEGs, you're transporting to other people. Make sure they're RGB, because CMYK does not look right in browsers or anything like that. So. Alright, Tony, dude. I'm going to bail out since I actually finished this. I'm going to get the heck out of here. Glad I got to chat with you even for a little bit. Yeah, the new schedule is basically why I've pretty much stopped doing streaming during the day, because I don't start till the mid-afternoon, and even then it's kind of waiting for Kaylee to wake up. She can wake up at any time. Like today she woke up too early, so you know, we had to go get her. But you know, it is what it is, you know, for now. And then once things get back to normal, I'll go back to some daytime streams, I guess. We shall see. But, alright, dude. We will see you later. Take care.